The Kremlin has denied Vladimir Putin is planning to quit as Russian president amid claims he is suffering from ill health and may step down as early as January. The 68-year-old strongman's future has been the subject of increasing speculation after prominent critic professor Valery Solovey suggested the leader had Parkinson's and that his family and lover Alina Khabiba had urged him to retire in the new year. But on Friday morning, Kremlin spokesman and deputy chief of staff Dmitry Peskov insisted Putin was in excellent health and dismissed the Parkinson's claims as complete nonsense. Asked if Putin was planning to step down in the near future as Solovey had suggested, Peskov said no, adding everything is fine with the president. It comes as it emerged that Putin is making retirement plans by introducing a new bill which would make him a senator for life and guarantee him lifelong immunity after office. Peskov's denial comes after Solovey last night said that Putin's gymnast lover Alina Khabiba, as well as his daughters Maria Vorontsova, 35, Katerina Tikhonova, 34, were urging him to step down. Footage has circulated in Russia of Putin's legs moving around as he gripped onto the armrest of a chair, suggesting his ill health. Eyes are also drawn to a twitching pen in the former KGB operative's fingers and a cup which analysts have suggested were filled with painkillers. It is not the first time that people have speculated that Putin may be suffering from Parkinson's disease. Others have previously noted his gunslinger's gait, a clearly reduced right arm swing compared to his left, giving him a lilting swagger. An asymmetrically reduced arm swing is a classic feature of Parkinson's and can manifest in clinically intact subjects with a predisposition to later develop the disease, according to the British Medical Journal. There is a family, it has a great influence on him. He intends to make public his handover plans in January, Solovey said. He suggested a new prime minister will soon be appointed by Putin, who will be groomed to take over. It comes as Putin is introducing plans to guarantee him immunity after office, which state-run RT media say will be seen as a sign that the groundwork is being laid for an eventual transition of power in Russia. Putin and any subsequent ex-president will be permitted within 3 months of leaving the presidency to become a member of the Federation Council, the country's upper house or Senate, for life. This is Russia copying the outdated British system of life peers in the House of Lords, said one Moscow source. Russian presidents are currently only protected for actions taken while they were in office, whereas the new law will guarantee them immunity for any alleged crimes committed before, during or after presidency. It would mean Putin would be protected over allegations of corruption which have persisted since the 1990s, when he was a deputy to the mayor of St. Petersburg. Politician and dissident Marina Sally accused him of embezzling tens of millions of pounds from the city in a food for export scheme, but an investigation was blocked by the mayor. The new law would also protect former president Dmitry Medvedev, who aroused suspicions after he gained a vast fortune, including luxury villas, yachts and a vineyard, after his presidency ended in 2012. The immunity law could only be revoked by a two-thirds majority in both houses of Russia's parliament if it is approved. But it would not grant Putin and other presidents from international courts. Many foreign critics have urged investigators to charge Putin for the Malaysia Airlines disaster in 2014, which was downed in eastern Ukraine, killing all 298 people on board. Putin has denied Russia's involvement, but investigators say the plane was brought down by separatists backed by the Kremlin, using a Buk missile, which had been supplied by the Russian military. The Russian leader's popularity ratings have fallen this year amid his handling of the coronavirus pandemic and poverty, and Putin could be looking to protect himself should the tide turn. The president's advisors have always poured scorn on the notion that his health is failing, and Putin has cultivated an athletic image. Riding horses, wrestling, playing ice hockey and swimming in frigid lakes. The law comes just 4 months after Putin changed the constitution to permit him a czar-like hold on power by seeking a new 6-year term in 2024 and again in 2030, meaning he would by 83, when he could relinquish power in 2036. Putin's spokesman Dmitry Peskov said of the senatorial shift, "This is the practice that is being applied in many countries of the world, and it is quite justified. This is not innovation from the point of view of international practice."